disappointments. There is this phrase you and I know it so well. When life gives you lemons, make a lemonade. Its intent is to encourage our discouraging days and find the good in them. Think about it. Think about one of the most amazing days in your life. What happened? What made it so great? Okay, now think about one of the most disappointing days in your life. What happened then? It's probably not something that you want to relive again, isn't it? But I like to share with you one of my disappointing days. It was back when I was in the 12th grade, where I had to submit a project on a particular topic, a biology project of 15 to 20 pages. And I worked day and night to make it perfect. I had put in all the details mentioned, and the day of submission came. While I was submitting, my teacher took my journal and she found out that there were so many things missing. When I knew and worked hard, that everything, I knew that everything was put in. But she was like, no, this was missing. And she liked that she humiliated me in front of the whole class. My heart just sank and I was so disappointed. So I did it a second time. I did the project starting from scratch. I did it again. Still, I went to her and she was not happy with it. And then finally, I did another one and she just accepted it because it was the final one. Let's face it, there are just those days that aren't that great, isn't it? Life can be tough, but God never promised that this life would be easy. That is what Jesus said in John chapter 16, verse 33. In this world, you will face persecution, but take heart, I have overcome the world. And if there is anyone else who knows how hard this life can be, wouldn't it be Jesus? Listen to the amazing hope and promise that He's giving us. He has overcome the world and He has come to give us peace. There is this similar reminder in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 16 and 18. It goes like this. So take heart, even though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. Because we look at not what is seen, but at what cannot be seen. For what is seen is temporary, and what cannot be seen is eternal. You will start to get the idea of what Jesus is giving us, a peace that is beyond anything that can ever happen in our lives. But does that mean everything is perfect? Not necessarily. But what He promises us is that if we look at things above the things of this life, if we look at Jesus, if we view with our spiritual eyes, we will see things differently. When the world sees chaos, we see peace. When we should lose hope, we find joy. It doesn't make sense, but it does. That is why St. Paul says in 2 Corinthians, we should not lose hope. Not only do we have the eternal hope, but we know that even when this world ends, our bodies will die. We will be with Jesus. But even if our bodies get old, and even when the world seems to be falling apart, we know that God is making all things new. The things that are eternal is not what the world sees. Jesus came into this world filled with darkness, death, and despair, and yet He turned things upside down. That is why we as God's people have a hope even in the darkest times, because we have a hope. We know that this world is not all that there is. We know that even if we are disappointed or frustrated, we have a strong anchor, our God who's there with us. In this life, we will face disappointment and hurts. But my dear brothers and sisters, don't lose heart. You're not alone. God loves you so much. And even when the times are tough, we know we can go to a person, to the one who understands disappointment like no one else. That someone was betrayed by his own friends. Someone who was misunderstood by those around him. And someone who seemed to have lost everything. And that is why his words are so clear in John chapter 16 verse 33. Take heart, I have overcome the world. In every battle, in every defeat, we still have a hope. The battle you're facing, I know it's difficult. I know it feels impossible. But I also know from Jesus' perspective that it's finished. It's finished. So, when you're feeling down, when you're feeling disappointed, we have a victory. We have a hope who understands disappointment like no one else. Consider believing Jesus' perspective and claiming a victory when you don't feel or look victorious. Take hope. Don't lose heart. Praise God. Hallelujah. So let's pray. Lord Jesus, come live in us. Lord Jesus, forgive us for the times we forgot you. Lord Jesus, during these times of disappointment and frustration, Lord, you are our only hope. And in you, we put our complete trust, putting aside everything and looking at things beyond what is seen. Looking at things through your eyes. Lord Jesus, our hope is you. And you are our friend during these times. We make this prayer in your mighty and matchless name. Amen. Praise God.